So I can't come to Utah and record my comedy album without talking about Mormons. Let's just address it, okay? So I went, last time I was here, I went to take a tour of the Mormon temple because that's what you're supposed to do when you visit Utah. I went, I took the tour, I went to the lady at the front desk. She was like, hey, how are you doing? I'm saying, hey, how are you doing? I'm here to take a tour of the temple. She said, oh, you can't go inside the temple. I was like, why? She's like, because I guess I'm not one of God's people. So I couldn't go inside the temple. But you can take a tour of the outside. And I was like, cool. She says, listen, the sisters are going to be with you in a moment. So the only thing I know about sisters is like people in habits. And so I was expecting some ladies in habits to come by and like Whoopi Goldberg to be behind them singing. But that didn't happen. That didn't happen. These two beautiful girls come, one Sister Smith, one Sister 17 consonants in her last name from a third world country. I don't know where she was from. They come, they take a tour. I give a beautiful tour. I'm like, listen, Sister Smith's like, hey, this is lovely, this is that. And I had a do the right thing moment. And I was like, hey, why y'all ain't got no brothers on the wall, man? She's like, excuse me? I said, where's all the brothers? She's like, oh, the brothers are like giving to. I'm like, no, the brothers. Why y'all, like, where's the black people on the walls? Do you guys let black people into your church? And she says, yes. And this is what she told me. She said, in 1864, we let the coloreds in. She said, coloreds, to me. Straight face. Sister Smith said, colored, straight face. And I said, excuse me? She says, yes, we let the coloreds in 1864. She says, we were for the coloreds, and we just didn't want anybody else to know because we were getting persecuted ourselves, so we didn't want to like tell anybody. And she's like, we gave money to the North during the Civil War. And I was like, yeah, but you also gave money to the South. Because you wanted the war to keep going so you could build your army. That is what was going on, right? And so she said 1864. And after I left, I did my research, and I found out that, you guys probably noticed, it's 1978 when they let black people in their church. And the only reason they let black people into the church is because the U.S. government said, if you don't let black people into your church, we're going to take away your tax-exempt status. And the prophet was like, wait one minute, God is talking to me right now. He said, let all these jive turkeys in. Come on, man. Jive turkeys. Because that's how all black people sounded in 1978. She did. She did. I learned a lot about the Book of Mormon. I learned that the Book of Mormon makes the Holy Bible into a trilogy. You have the Old Testament, you have the New Testament, and you have the Book of Mormon. But the Book of Mormon is definitely the Godfather 3 of the trilogy. It is definitely, it was made like years later. It probably didn't need to be made, but if you like it, people think you're kind of weird. Like that is how it is. I've taken a lot of interest in Mormons, and I learned there's some urban legends about Mormons. I heard about this thing called soaking. And I don't even know what soaking is. It's like you just put, like they don't believe in premarital sex, so I think, yeah, just put it in, you just let it soak. Like soaking, no stroking. Like that's what I heard. You know how hard that would be? Like, imagine if that was like a challenge on Survivor. Like, tonight on Survivor, we're just soaking. Like, oh, Jeff, it's so hard. Like, oh, you're out. You're voted off the island. You're off the island. I learned what a Mormon blowjob was. A Mormon blowjob is like a regular blowjob that doesn't happen. That is... Mormon blowjob. Yeah, yeah.